start of the recording. I think I'll give the control to Nupur. Control, I think you can directly take there, Nupur. So,
yeah, Gokul.
So what we did was, me, Nupur, and Sintil, we discussed few actions, like how we are going to conduct this meeting, so what is the action needed, and we discussed with the captains as well. So what we'll do is, I'll let Nupur and Sintil handle this. Okay.
So,
over to you, Nupur, and somebody who is or not muted. There's some background noise.
Yeah, Gokul?
Yes, Nupur, you can start. I think we'll start now. Thank you.
Okay, so yeah, as everybody knows, yeah, so today's agenda is like we have five tasks. Each team, okay? So let's start with the first one, which is by Hana Guru, and the task owner is Brian. So once they give the presentation, Brian and all other can ask the question to them, okay? But yeah, please consider the time. Presentation would be for 10 minutes and 5 minutes question answer.
Who is going to present it?
Sachin will be doing it.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Hi, Gokul.
Your hi should be for all, not just for me.
Hi, everybody.
Correct.
Hi,
Sachin. Hi, good evening. Okay, I'm just sharing my screen. To see my screen, Gokul?
Yeah, Sachin, just to start with, you can just give some basic idea about what is their topic and what you guys have tried to do. So give some background, then I think you can just quick summary, then you can immediately go to the system. Yeah.
Okay. My task was to add one custom tab in a BP transaction. My task was add custom transaction in a BP transaction by using the BDT. In this task, basically what we need to do, the development, total part of the development is just we need to create one subscreen by using the function group, and then rest of the things was like assignment of the subscreen to the application and the data set. So I just, let me log in and let me show you.
Okay. While you logging in, so a request to all members, so these sessions are for your use. So you have to utilize it. So anything not clear, anything, suppose we want to stop him or whoever is presenting, please stop him, ask questions, try to understand. This is more of, to share knowledge. So don't hesitate. If you want to understand why exactly BP is important, go ahead and ask him. Okay, probably... I'll let Sachin answer on that, and please ask questions. So it'll be more interesting. If only one person is talking, but it'll not be that much, interactive. So please expect questions from not just the task owner, from everybody. Yeah. Thank you. Sorry, Sachin. Please go ahead.
Okay. Thanks, Gokul, for the information. Okay. What I did is first I have created for one application by using BUPT transaction, then I have created the data set. Then we need to create the field groups, and the field needs to be assigned. And this field needs to be available on the subscreen which we have created. And then we need to create the view, and this view needs to be assigned to the subscreen which I have created, like the custom subscreen. I can say the custom subscreen which we created. And then we need to create the sections, and section needs to assign to the views. And then we need to create one parent screen, which will be containing over the subscreen. Okay. After that, we need to create the screen sequence, and this screen sequence will be assigning with the screen which the parent screen which we have created earlier step. After that, we need to create the the main role, or maybe we can assign the subscreen to the existing role, or we can create the custom role as well. And this role needs to be assigned with the views. After that, we need to assign the application, custom application, to this data set. Okay, let me run the BP transaction. To give the overview of the BP transaction, generally in SAP ERP system, we create the customers, vendor with the different transaction. Like for the customers, we use the XD01, for the vendor XK01, like this. But in S4HANA, we need to use only one transaction as a BP, which will, you know, basically create the customer, take care of the customer and the vendor part. Then how it will be differentiate? The customers and vendors will be differentiate or identified by using the business partner role. So this is of the advantage of the BP transaction in S4HANA. I have created one role. I have not touched any standard role to add the custom tab. So I thought, let's create one custom role as well and assign the subscreen to the custom role. So I have created one custom role called as a custom BP. And if you see, I have assigned already existing standard view, which was containing the address, identification, control, and status. And my custom tab was BP role additional. So this tab is there, and I have added only one field as a business partner. I have not made any coding which will save this business partner into the tables. So that's it from my side. Brian, is this the right task which you have given?
Yes, Sachin. It's perfect.
Thank you.
Anybody want to ask any questions?
Brian, is that a deal, Brian? You should ask some more questions, huh? Okay. So otherwise, probably I'll start asking questions. Sachin. Any other questions from others, first of all? No? Okay. So whatever you showed in the, whatever configurations you showed there, so those are the things which are used to create this screen, as I understand. Okay, so which, hello, can you hear me? There's some background noise there. The main question is about the field what you added. I see that you added one field, business partner. Now I was expecting people to at least ask. Okay, if you just showed only about configuration, suddenly you were showing that in the BP tab you see a field. So do we need to add some field somewhere? Do we need to mention a screen somewhere? I don't know. You're not covering that, but I know there is a configuration there. But where exactly you're covering that?
I thought I had covered this last session, so I have not gone in deeply for this session. So if you want, I will cover these things again.
Only the last part, maybe in the configuration SAP itself, if we can show that business partner, this is the field which we showed. This is in the custom tab you showed. Okay, so I'm just trying to understand how do you configure it? How do you control it? Some background disturbances there, I don't know why. Is it only for me? I don't know.
No, Google, not from our side. We have kept you mute for a minute.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, sorry.
Okay. Okay, till the time it gets login, let me brief you with the steps. First, I have created one function group, and in the function group, I have created one screen. So my screen number is 9001, that is a custom screen. And I have not created any GUI status for this, as this is a subscreen which we need to use under the tab. So, and I have added one field in the subscreen. Then I use the transaction as a BUS1. So you can go into the BUPT code and down you will be see the application. And when you click on the application, you need to create your own custom application. I have created with the Jade app. And then you need to create one data set with the transaction BUS23. Creating the data set, you need to create the field groups. You need to create with any number. This is not like you have to specify or take the reference of the number. You can randomly give any field number. So you can create the field group with the number. And then with the field group, by using the field group, you need to assign the fields which you have created on your subscreen. After that, you need to create one view. And inside the view, you need to assign the subscreen and the function group program name, the main program name which you have created at the first stage. And in the view, you have to give the application as well as data set. Okay. In the view, I see one important point that differential type. Differential type is nothing but where you wanted to add your additional tab, like in general data, or maybe some different roles are available there. Credit management role is there. So from differential type, you can identify or assign the application and your data set and the screen number and program name over there. After creating the view, you need to assign the field groups to the view. Then you need to create one section in the BUS4 transaction. And after creating the section, you need to assign the view which you have created to the section. After creating the section, you need to create one screen, that is a parent screen, which I have told. This parent screen will hold your subscreen. So this parent, in the parent screen, you have to give the section, create the screen section as well. In section, for this section, this will be containing maybe your general data tab or header data tab. So I have created one section, custom section with the general header tab. After that, you have to create one screen sequence. And following the screen sequence, you have to give number to the screen sequence as well. So this would be also a random number which you can specify any number. Then you have to create one screen sequence category. And for the screen sequence category, you have to give the screen sequence number, I think.
That's okay. Okay. I think so there are quite a few configurations, I think, as I understand. Now, naturally, the next question is about where do we write our code? Now, I see that you have a custom screen and custom program where you'll be able to write a code for all these custom fields. Fine. Just to add, suppose for standard fields, suppose we want to add more validation. Okay. So mm-hmm. You know where exactly you should add that? Any idea?
We have created one subscreen, right? So we have the PBO and PI module as well.
No, that part is clear. So wherever you see for custom fields, I think you'll be able to do that in the PBO PI. my question is somewhat related to that, but it's a different one. In the standard screen itself, you see there are quite a few screens, you have it there, right? So if you want to add any more validation, so they know how to do it, like, again, you have to look at user exit, or is there a different way available for BP?
No, for validation, I'm not aware. You are basically talking about the validation or the data which you are going to enter in the subscreen that need to be saved some standard standard table or something.
Subscreen part is clear. So the question is more about, okay, let's say, still your system is opening, is it? Well, in BP transaction, there are quite a few tabs. So maybe for a customer, if you, let's say, there is a new requirement in your standard screen, you want to add more validation. Okay, I'll try to give the answer there itself. Now the point is you don't have to look for the user exit or something. So the configuration what is put there, in if you go through that document, I think in many places you'll see that there is a provision to enter a custom function model there. Okay. So
okay.
Main point is that you don't have to look for any
user exit
or other maybe enhancements or something for this. You do have provisions to add custom function module. And you do have options to add at different stages as well. Okay, so this configuration is very important. This particular transaction and the configuration is very important from S/4HANA perspective, because whatever you do in customer master, vendor master, you're going to replicate here. You're going to do it here once you have S/4HANA.
Okay.
So in that way, this is important. And that's why I asked this question. Suppose we have completely custom tab, just like what Sachin showed, it's quite straightforward. But if you want to add validation in for standard fields, that is also possible without impacting the standard screen. You have provisions in this configuration itself. You'll be able to add refunction modules, validations, or any other thing. You'll be able to add custom function modules in which you'll write your code.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, Brian, question to you, Brian. Brian is the owner, right?
Yes.
I know you already said the task is completed, but let me, tell me something. This is about a tab, Brian. So is it possible to add a new field in any of the other existing tabs, Brian? Ask me the question, so I should ask you this. I was expecting you to push ask questions. Huh? So tell me, instead of new tab, I want to add any of the existing screen. Is it possible? Or no?
Yes.
Yeah, very short, answer. I'm looking for a better, lengthy one.
Yeah, you'll work on it then.
Okay, so I think Sachin, you want to comment on this, Sachin?
I have one question. Like, we have the BP transaction ECC as well. We use somewhere in ECC. So what's the major difference holding with the S/4HANA and the ECC part?
The first part you already mentioned there. Now in S/4HANA, you're not going to see the hierarchy wise, BP is going to sit on top of customer and vendor. Okay, so for many reporting purpose, or many FA related reason, and there are even you can enter maintain multiple addresses. So for that, there are other reasons as well. For that purpose, now hierarchically you have an extra this thing, which is your business partner on top of your vendor and a customer. So In your SAP system, this is going to sit on top of your customer master, vendor master. So anything you want to create, you're going to create in BP itself. As you were showing, you'll create it with the corresponding role. You're going to create a customer, you'll create with the corresponding customer role in BP transaction. And in background, it'll go back, it'll create the customer as well, and it'll go to tables KNA1. Well, apart from the BP tables, it'll go to KN star tables as well. You do not create your customer again. Keep that in mind. Similarly, vendor is. So in that way, you're creating one entity. For example, if your customer is acting as a vendor in a different business scenario, in this case, okay, so both are interlinked now. So in your reports, you will be able to see for this particular entity, one entity which is acting as a customer in some cases and acting as a vendor in some cases, you'll be able to list out in your report. So that is the reason. So that is the main reason why they have created this. And there are a lot of other reasons, like, I was talking about addresses. I think even some of the FA reports will be, we'll be using this information as well. So main thing is that you want to see one entity for, you know, both customer and vendor as well. That is the main reason we have created. Okay. Right. I think you're thanks, Sachin. I think you're any other questions from anybody? But I want you to ask questions, yeah.
I think Gokul, that's enough, I think, because it's been
time
20 off. Minutes.
Right, let's go to our timekeeper. Thanks.
Okay, okay, so I think the task is completed by Sachin, so I'll just move this task
to close,
okay?
You should ask Brian, huh?
Brian,
yeah,
come on, Brian. It's done, right?
Confirm. Bye-bye, Mukofius. Actually, can we have that Word document, Word file like he has given in the step one, step two, like that? So can we have that in this? So we can later we can refer
Sachin,
and if there any doubts, we can again approach him.
Can you share?
I have it. I will forward.
Yeah.
I will forward to the captain. Or captain may circulate it.
Yeah. Put it in the Trello. Put it in a lab. You can share it to Sendhil. He'll put it in Altresco, and he'll share it. He'll share the link.
Okay.
Okay, so let's move ahead with the second task, which will be presenting by Rachna from Hana Crackers.
Thank you, Nupur. Hello, everyone. Can you see my screen?
Wait.
Okay, my topic was ATC, and last time I had shown different rules, and today I will be showing the demo how we had done. So basically we will start with the T code ATC. ATC stands for ABAP test cockpit. So it is basically used for checking the ABAP programs. Whatever program we have coded, we have to see if it is for custom code adaptation. So first we will go to T code ATC, then we will go to schedule runs, and we have to create a series here, and using the code inspector check variant, we have we can check and modify our changes as to what checks are required. So first I will show you how that there are errors in my program, and after that I will show you how I have removed it and how there are no errors, and it is success. It will be able to move it to HANA system.
Yep.
So first I will schedule this. We can see that the check run is successfully scheduled. We go back. And there, this is in the state of running. So once it is finished, we can see the result. And here we can see what are the errors we are getting. Also, we can see the statics as to which error and which mistake is given the priority. So now we will go back to our program. This is the program. If you all remember, last time I had told about different rules to be followed. And I will repeat again, there are several rules which we have to follow, like the rule number one is we have to avoid select star statements. Instead, we should be using the name of the fields. And the second rule is we have to remove select statement with delete statement. So what I will be doing is I will, okay, the third rule is search for bypassing buffer statement, and that is not to be included here. The fourth rule is to remove the native SQL statements. The fifth rule to be taken care is about the DB hints, that is the index. Index is specified for a index is specified for a particular database, so we don't have to use it here. Then we have to use order by clause, and where sort statement is there, and also we have to delete adjacent duplicates like this. And the eighth rule is to, like we use in ABAP, read table should be followed by binary search. So what, now that you all have seen that whatever errors we are facing, so now I will just comment, this code, and I will run it. So this, the commented code, so this is the correct statement of the rule, and I'm just commenting the wrong statements. For every rule, I have written particular statements, and the wrong code that we have written is commented. Okay, I've just you can see that the program is activated, and now we'll go again to ATC check. We will schedule the test. Also, we can see that we have used the variant. Here we can use different variants. The variant that we used is HANA S4 readiness. Now we will just schedule. We can see that the run is scheduled. We'll go back. We will just monitor and check if there are any errors or if it is ready to move it to the system.
Refresh.
Yeah. So we will see the result. And now we see that there are no errors. That means it is clear and we can move it to the system.
Okay, I just want to add one small point, Rachna. Sorry, yeah, just questions. ATC is good. Now, when you run ATC,
yeah,
you'll be able to see the errors. You'll be able to, probably some of you probably might be wondering, like, again, there is a lot of manual effort involved. So I just want to answer that.
Yes.
So ATC,
yeah, yeah.
You're covering that?
Yes. Actually, we had some problem, like when we were creating our program, and when we wanted to execute it, we were having a problem saying that we had to upload the simplification database. So that time we just found out that simplification database contains all the simplification items, and that has to be that which we have to download from the marketplace. So then we had to contact the basis person, and then we imported the file using SYCMT code.
Now, let me, because you're showing something simplification, something about simplification database. I know what is a simplification database. Let me ask one of you guys. So, other captains, who can you can tell us what is a simplification database? Apart from you, your captain, huh? Maybe.
Okay, so.
Have one second.
Okay, so basically, so the rules she told, so they are not specific to S4HANA, okay? So they are even applicable for HANA database system, okay? So there is a difference between S4HANA compatibility and HANA database compatibility. So one major thing between S4HANA and normal HANA database is the availability of the tables. So we all know that we have the simplified tables in S4HANA, which are not there in the traditional HANA database. For example, if you open your example, the report which you have created.
Yes.
Okay, so there she has used the MATDOC table, okay? She has used it. Go down, you have used @MATDOC, something like, you have commented it, okay? But, the idea was tables like MSEC and other tables, primitive tables which are there in the traditional database, they are not going to be useful in the S4HANA system because we would have the consolidated database table. So that is the difference between S4HANA and the traditional HANA database. So now, simplified database content, so in ATC, that is the most important thing because that will show me what are available in S4HANA and what is not. So, if I run
small correction, is it Brian or who is speaking? Just want to understand.
This is Chandrasekhar Gopal.
Okay, sorry, Chandra. That's a very good answer.
Yeah.
Just want to add some points there, because it's not 100% correct answer, but still, I think you are approximately there. You're almost there.
Okay.
So, good answer. But just want to add, so simplification database, yeah, it's not just about the modified tables. Huh? So, if you see, it's more of a zip file provided by SAP. If you go to your service marketplace.
Yes, in the market.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, it will give you a zip file. Basically, it contains all the changed items. So, for example, for S4HANA perspective. Okay, there is a big list of, it's not just about tables, okay. For example...
Yeah, it's not about tables, it contains all the changes which is there in S4HANA and which is not in, there in the traditional HANA data. Yeah, and I think the latest 7.3 or something, we need to download it, and even a developer also can upload it. So then only your ATC would be like that S4HANA readiness. So the engine is basically the simplified database content. Like if you have not uploaded the zip file in your system, then your ATC will fail to recognize whether the program is actually compatible with S4HANA system or not. Right, Gopal?
Perfect, Sandra. Thanks. Anybody, I think is it clear for you? If other people, any questions you have to Chandra, guys?
Excuse me, Gokul, I'll just execute the program because we had a task of MIGO details, showing MIGO details.
Yeah, please go ahead. Thanks.
Yeah, so since there is no data in this, so if there was data in this, it would have executed properly.
One more point which I wanted to add, quick one.
Yeah.
So the manual changes what you've done. This is very important. Guys, this is very important. So you went to the program and you manually changed it, right? So you saw ATC, ATC gave you the analysis that, okay, this is wrong or this is something which you need to change. It's not wrong.
Yes.
But if you go to S4HANA in Eclipse, If you go there, there is a new option. Okay, new one. It's not new.
Okay.
It's an option called Quick Fix.
Okay.
Okay. So there, once you use it, okay, it will automatically change the code itself. Huh? It's very important, guys. So there are quite a few OSS now. So if you have any time, just try to search for Quick Fix. The term Quick Fix, even in Service Market Plus or Google it, you'll be able to see there are a lot of related things. So Quick Fix, you will just have to right click. Check, you'll be able to run your ADC there itself. You'll be able to right click and say Quick Fix. It will correct the program also. You don't have to, you know, go to the program and manually correct it. So this is another option. So probably in future, once you completely migrate to S/4HANA, probably we'll have more options than Quick Fix. Mostly people will be using more of this Quick Fix thing. Yeah. So
Thank you everyone. I'll stop sharing my.
Yeah, I think there's one more question here. Somebody has asked.
I just want two clarifications. First thing is, we are removing the native SQL statements from the query that we are. Is it always that we need to mandatory remove those native SQL will not work with HANA, or how it will be? And secondary thing also, we have removed the usage of index. So there is no usage of indexes in that. We don't need to create the secondary indexes at all.
Actually, those were the rules. So we have just used it in our example to show it.
So we can still use native SQL statements, whether it will work. Though it might be a
Shriram, I don't think native SQL will work in HANA database.
Yeah, to answer that, okay. So when you talk about native SQL, see, HANA is a database. We're talking about HANA database. When you say native SQL, it is DB-specific code. It is DB-specific code. Now, you're talking about a current program. If you have a native SQL, so that means, okay, your current SQL actually is written to work for your Oracle database or, I don't know, maybe SQL or other databases. So when you migrate your system to HANA database, obviously it will not work. Okay, so that means you have two options. Either remove the native SQL, whatever is written there, use OpenSQL, basically ABAP code, or look for HANA-specific native SQL. Suppose, just make sure your SQL, what you write there, works for your HANA database. In that way, you cannot say that your native SQL will not work completely in HANA DB, but you have to make sure it works for HANA DB. Okay, since you're changing your database completely. So that is the key point here. And second one, secondary index is not obsolete. It is still there. So it's still there, it'll work, but it's not that significant. Since now we're talking about column use, your tables are all column use. Most of the tables, not all. So the significance of your secondary index is reduced now completely. So, but still it is still there, and you'll be able to create it only for certain cases. It will not be that effective, frankly speaking. But it's still there. Technically, you'll be able to create your secondary index instead. Okay. Any other questions? Hope this is clear. Guys, any other questions, or we'll move on to the next topic? Kapilan, we need comment from you. Kapilan, this is Kapilan's task, right? Task owner?
Google, it's from my team. This is Neeraj.
Neeraj team, sorry. Sir, Neeraj.
Google, I think they have done it correctly as what was expected. So this can be closed.
Perfect.
So for now, the HANA migrator, they were supposed to give presentation on different tasks, but since they are facing some issue, or they have
task has been changed,
they were supposed to give this create NOE custom field task was given to them, but now they are supposed to give presentation on explore empty data. Yeah, so they have changed their task. it is assigned to them. So now.
Correct. This is already discussed. This is not something which they individually change. So this is all discussed and then it was decided. Yeah.
So, hi all, this is Ankit and my task is to explore SD data model changes related to SD index tables. So here we have 6 SD related tables, index tables. These are VKPA, VAPMA, VLKPA, VLPMA, VRKPA and VRPMA. So these tables have their DBL source and also their CDS views. So these tables are not directly extended. We need to create some views to extend it. Like I am taking example of one table that is VAPMA. So VAPMA has a proxy object which is this V_VAPMA. And the CDS view for this object is V_VAPMA_CDS. So this contains the these three tables, VBAK, VBAP and VBPA, records from these three tables. And the DBL source will contain the query regarding
Sorry for interrupting. So like, what is the proxy object? You are showing some proxy object, now. So can you just give us some small idea about proxy object?
So yeah, proxy object will be your definition of the view. Just like here, this is the proxy object. This is the proxy object for VAKPA table. So proxy object is nothing but the definition of the table. So and the proxy object will contain a view, a CDS view. When we define, it will contain two objects. One is proxy object and one is CDS view. So CDS view is generally created in the, our dictionary table, and proxy object will contain all its definition like this. When we define a view, we define it as a proxy object.
Kapila, are you happy with that?
Not that much.
So maybe if you want to add that point, please go ahead.
Yeah, like each
we define it with a proxy object.
Yeah, no problem, Ankit. I think you've given the part answer is right, but still I'll request Kapil to add other points. Yeah.
Yeah, as it is there, like in this VAPMA, like all the not just this one, like all the other 6 index table, like everything will be already will have this proxy object. This is like kind of linking the table to the CDS view. Like if you write a code, it will write a query or something like on VAPMA, then it will take it to that CDS view and then that DDL source view. So that what we term it as proxy. You can correct me, Google, if I'm wrong.
Right. I think, we're almost there, don't worry. So we're almost there. So just to summarize, both of you, the thing is, in SAP, in S/4HANA, you have some tables which are already placed. But in your custom code, assume that you have used all these tables, let's say MSEC, RV, APMA. SAP, they don't want you to rewrite all these codes. So that is the reason they have introduced this this concept, which is proxy objects. Now in the current version 18.09, if you see, the name is changed to replacement object. Huh? It's not proxy object anymore. So what this is doing is, this is in a CDS view, and so instead of VAPMA, it is going to get the data from somebody somewhere else. For example, in your example. And what that means is your custom code, which basically selects the data from VAPMA, will still work. You don't have to change your code. So that's why it says proxy. Instead of VAPMA, you're going to get the data from, what is the current one? V underscore VAPMA. In MSEC, if you go to MSEC, proxy object some name is something like NSDG, something will be there. What that means is, if you have in your custom code, if there is a select which selects the data from MSEC, or even if you go to SC16N, give MSEC, look for n number of entries, it will give you the number of entries, it will give you the entries. But actually, there's no data saved in MSEC. Instead of that, the data is saved in MADDOC table, which is the new table, new replacement table for MSEC. But still, the proxy object is the linking factor between your MSEC and MADDOC. So you don't have to change your code. You don't have to rewrite all your programs for that purpose. And that is the reason this concept is introduced. And for that purpose, they've created a CDS view. And if you go inside the CDS view, they'll have a select from the replaced object or new table. In the case of MSEC, if you go inside the CDS view, there will be a select from MADDOC and all, and you'll be able to see the data from there. Okay, that's why they call it as replacement object or proxy object.
So here, you know, for example, VAPMA does not have any records. It is taking records from VBAK and VBAP tables.
Exactly.
So to extend this VAPMA table, we have to create a compatibility view. So I will show you how to create a compatibility view. So this is the view that I have created using right click. In the package, when I right click and new other object repository, then here I'll go to CDS core data service, and then I'll give the data definition. Then I'll give the name here and create the view. So this is how the coding will be generated. I will give the CDS view name, that is z_v_vpma_cds, and this will be the proxy object, define view z_vpma as, and then I will write the select query under it. So this select query should be same as whatever in the VAPMA proxy object. So it will contain all the same. I'm creating a compatibility view to extend the VAPMA table. Once I have given all the select query, I will then extend the VAPMA view, CDS view that I have created. It will contain this code, extend view VAPMA with the extension name, and what will you want to extend is included inside that view. After the inclusion, once we run this code, it will show MAT KL is added in the view. Here we can see the object here. This is the CDS view we have created, compatibility view for VAPMA. It is containing this proxy object, and our extension is added at the end. This one, MATKL. And our this view contains, means when we write the select query, there are some cases in the table, like in VB type, there are two cases when A and B, it will take datap, else it will take GP. And there are also different cases we can include in the view. I am showing you example of this. In this view, we don't have VB type as A or B. I am changing it to 28. So when I run this, that B will be changed. So whatever we do the changes in our view, it will be reflected in our table.
So basically the idea is here in SD index table, we cannot directly extend the CDS view provided by SAP. So we have to create the compatibility view for this. So we have to copy the exact thing from the existing standard view, and then we have to create another extended view to add the enhanced attributes there. So it will be available there. Also in CDS view, there are many things possible, like cases and also union all. There are many things possible in CDS view. So that's it from our end.
Anybody have any questions?
Any other question? Anybody?
Is there any way that we can is there any way
here,
to
Vikram?
Yeah, please.
From Vikram, we have a question.
Basically, this extension are not manually, right, Prachi? Because we have to.
Yeah, we are doing it via extension. Actually, see, the way we have created a CDS view, in a similar way, we can create our extend view. So there, if we go to the screen here, extend view, we have to mention which view we are extending, and with we have to mention the new extended view name, and whatever fields we want to add there, that we have to mention here, and also we have to mention from which table it is referring to. So it will so the reference should be there from which table we are using, because it will create the reference in the view. If you go and check in SE11, there the table and the field name will be available there. Otherwise here it will give you some error for that.
So I just wanted to understand why the standard view can't be extended.
For SAP index table, they are saying that we cannot directly extend that view because the perspective layer is not available. So any manipulation like update, delete, or adding anything is not possible there. So that's why if it is a SAP index table, we have to always create a compatibility view. So suppose in your report there are select queries, and if that your table is not extended or any append structure is not there, then you don't have to change anything there. But if there are some append structure are there, so you have to create the compatibility view, and in every select query you have to change it. Otherwise there is
use standard view
if there are any enhancement is done in that table, then no, you cannot use that, because it will not refer to the additional columns or fields available there. For that you have to create a, otherwise that data will be lost.
No, that was my issue. See, we have something in standard table, okay? So
yeah,
if we are able to extend standard view, so automatically the fields will be appended at the bottom.
Now
you are standard table with
No, we are not replacing, we are just creating a compatibility view. That view will always be there. But if you are using it in your report or anywhere, then that time you have to do it.
Okay. So
we are just fetching record from the standard table and collecting in the view. Select query is written is in the view.
Okay.
Any other questions?
So just open your CDS compatibility.
Before going out for the extension, can we check, is there any way to identify these views are already existing or not? It might be
so from object we can check it.
Sorry, we are not aware of it. Google, can you help
it? You want to check whether the view is available?
Yeah, before I'm going to extend a particular view, if I want to verify it rather than just going in the background and seeing SE11, is there any other way that I can identify there are a set of views are available in standard or some other Z views are already existing?
Yeah, the purpose is different. So, why they've extended is they've can you hear me? Yeah. So here BPMA story is a bit different actually. So in other cases, when you want to create a completely new CDS view, that is a different discussion. You can directly go to SE11. You can give the DDL source name in SE11 and you'll be able to see it there actually. But here the purpose why you created a new view is like, you know, the proxy object what Ankit showed earlier, B_VAPMA. Okay, there is a specific instruction somewhere, right? Actually, you will not be able to extend directly there. And that is the reason, in this case, they have created a new, CDS view, okay, which can be used for extending it. Because here, I think the purpose is to add a new field, MATKL, sorry. So, at the end, so they will not be able to do it in the existing view, which is V_VAPMA. SAP has suggested. The reason is, VAPMA is a secondary index table, unlike MSEC or something. VAPMA is a secondary index table which depends on the data from VBAC and VBAP. So that's the reason they said, okay, don't extend V_VAPMA, create a new Z CDS view. That is the main reason they created this one and then extended it.
Okay.
Okay. And if you want to check it, you can always go, again, you can very well go to SE11, you'll be able to go to the proxy of the copy that. V_then you will be able to check it in SE11 itself directly.
So from background we can verify.
Correct. You can check it.
To add here is whenever you create a compatibility view, you have to follow the sequence, otherwise it will give you an error. Like you have to define all the fields in the same sequence which are there in the standard view, and after that only you can extend it.
Okay, so Kapil, are you okay with the task
we have?
Yeah.
Yes, I'm okay with this.
Three are done, two more are pending. So maybe you can check with the team whether is it okay to wait for some more time, because time is there. I mean, we already reached time, but you need to check with the team. I think that is okay to, if they are okay, I think all are okay then.
I think yes, they are okay. I think your people are okay, so we can go ahead with the next step. Okay, so Brian will be sharing the screen.
Hello. Hi all.
Hello.
Hello,
yeah,
Brian.
Brian here. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. So our topic is AMDP, ABAP Managed Database Procedure. Okay, as I told you earlier, the motive of the AMDP is to push the logic to the database layer. Okay, by which we can enhance the performance. Okay, so our task is to display the sales order details. So we have created the AMDP for it, but we don't have the data. So we have created another AMDP with the S-flight table. Okay, so first I'll show you the sales order AMDP. Okay, so to create the AMDP, we need to right click on the project and create a new class. Okay, and in which in class definition we need to include this interface IF underscore AMDP marker HDB HANA database. Okay, once we done that, we'll declare the variables. Then we define the method. After that, in the class, in the method implementation, we need to define this syntax for the method. Okay, we need to declare whichever tables we are using. Okay, to fetch the data. Here we are only reading the data from the database, so we use it as a read only. We can also use it write as a write only or read only. Okay, so in this okay, this is the SQL. Hello. Okay, so in this class, in this method, we have fetched the data from the VBAK, VBAP, and VBUP. So, but we don't have the data, so we have created another AMDP. Okay, with the same procedure, in which we are fetching only the. Okay, I'll show you. Okay, so in this method, we are fetching the sum of the capacity of the flights. Okay, so in normal ECC, what we would have done is we will fetch all the records, then loop on the records and sum, find the sum of the corresponding records. So to do this, we need to fetch all the records, and it will consume a lot more time. So in this, what we have done is we have passed the flight ID and do the sum and pass only one record from the database to the application layer. Okay. So once we activate it, this class in SE24. We will able to display this class. Okay, it will get automatically created here. Okay, so to consume this, so we have created two programs. One is with the normal procedure. We have loop on the records, do the sum, and display the sum. Okay, so this will display the sum. Okay, and we have created another program with AMDP procedure consumption. Okay, so we have used this class which we have created Eclipse. Okay, we have used this method, pass the flight ID, get the sum, and display the sum. Okay, so we have run this program and find out the time consumption. So it is showing difference. Okay, so it is improving the performance of the program. So, but we don't have a lot data, a lot more data in the program. So, in the table, so it's marginal. So, this is the procedure to create a AMDP class. Okay, and yeah. So, this is a the program with the AMDP class. We have also created a program for the sales order display, but we don't have records, so it's not getting displayed. Okay, so any questions?
Who is the task owner, by the way? Is it the frame team, is it? Frame, no?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Prem will have more questions. Prem, come on, Prem.
Yeah, okay. So my question is like the same example which you have demonstrated using AMDP. Anyone could have done with the CDS views as well. So then what is the difference between AMDP and CDS view?
Wow, very nice question.
Yeah.
Who is that?
Yeah,
who is
even
that?
The CDS.
Chandra. Chandra is your Hala Guru. Come on, sir. Super.
No, but yeah, that is genuine thing. Like, he has given two options.
It's a very good question. It's a very good question. Yeah.
And now one more question adding to that. Instead of doing that, x is equal to x plus y to find the sum inside the loop. In the traditional DB, I could have done using that group by clause.
Yes, I know. Even we can.
So then.
I just want to show you is we can do the we have created the case here, okay. In this case, we can we could have also write the lot many functions, so we can push these functions to database layer.
So yes.
Okay. So we have created a dummy task. So.
So coming to the first question,
yeah.
CDS also gets created in the database.
Yeah, but
correct.
I have not worked.
And one question you Gopal as well in the previous example, they created the CDS views, but how to identify whether that is actually created in the database layer or it's just that we see in the SE11? Because SE11 is not the database layer, right? It's just a projection. But how to know that whether it has actually been created in the database layer?
Because you saw, okay, to answer the this thing, if you saw that the CDS view definition when Ankit was showing in the top, there are three or four lines are there, and it basically helps you to identify whether it's a CDS view or not. Okay, and the definition, the first part will tell you whether it's a normal view or it's a CDS view or not. So that is more than enough to identify whether you can use that as a CDS view. Okay. So normal view, you don't have to go there, and we can create it in SAP itself. Absolutely. Okay, and you want to see it, probably we need to go back and check it, but yeah, you can go to the system and you can check it anyway. So but just check the first few lines, that will give you an idea, like, you know, how exactly it is defined. That is the normal definition.
Okay.
So CDS views are already created, always created at database level. As Sandra was saying, see, these are two important concepts in S4HANA, CDS view and AMDP classes. Very important when you go for S4HANA. These two concepts are used to make sure your application logic, is, you know, run at database layer, not at the application layer. So that is the key difference. So when you're going for HANA DB, your complex logic should run at database layer, and you just get the data after all the calculation, show only the data in front end. That's what we're trying to do, and these two helps us in that. Okay. And what is the difference? Probably I'll let others to help in this. Actually, more than me, I think I need help from either Frame or you know, others. I don't know. Maybe I'll let you guys focus. Frame, you want to answer that, or we'll.
Both CDS and AMDP is code custom technology, so that will be executed in database. In CDS, we have a procedure that is very lightweight. Okay, so it can, we have very minimal set of logic that can be executed. If you use AMDP, you can write so complex query. So both results, AMDP, I think CDS is bit faster, and AMDP is bit slow because it takes some complex queries.
Example, you know, what can be of interest? Any example that you've come across?
CDS and AMDP,
what does CDS cannot do
with an AMDP? AMDP, for example, it can run in SQL database also. But for now, they have made, yeah, so it can run in HTTP only.
KLDs are also
being
incorporated in AMDP.
Yes, they cannot. Even, but you can consume CDS in AMDP.
You can consume that, but in AMDP, you can write an AMDP there.
Yes, it can be directly called, that will be a single line call, yeah. That you cannot do in CDS. Yeah. So you want to add any point?
So reusability is another point. Let's work on that. I think there are a few other points as well. Like, you know, how often you want to use it, that is also another factor, I think, whether to go for CDS view and you want to utilize as a class, similar to the way you decide whether you want to create a class or you want to create a database. If you ask me the same question, okay, similar to that. So that is also another factor which decides. And CDS view is used in many other places, not just for one program usage. You know, it's more of a, you want to create a database view and which can be accessible in many places. So assume it's more of a database view, and class
CDS is consumed in theory also, just to add your
analysis.
Correct, exactly. So it depends on the usage as well, where do you want to use it, so that is also another factor. And there can be other reasons as well. Probably I need help. Who was presenting it? Okay.
Yes, Gokul, me, Brian.
Okay, so LP to find out the difference, yeah. So maybe one or two very good examples, the differences, maybe you can help to find out and share it with the whole team, please. Okay, this is one task we can add, and because this is a very important topic, and anybody else, maybe Prem, this is, again, we can, Prem and Brian can work on that, if others can also pitch in, get the differences and you can share it with the team, since it's a very important topic. Okay, we should, I think, clearly
share.
So, apart from what we discussed, maybe I'll also be eager to understand, because some of the points probably I'll also go and refer. So, okay, help me in that. Okay, Brian, action with Brian. So I think we are expecting two differences from you and Prem as well. Two more.
Yes, Gokul. Yeah, sure.
Thank you. That was a good question, Chandra. Others?
So.
Okay. So, Prem, what do you think? The task is completed?
Yes. So, apart from the Gokul, so you think you can put in closed or on hold, because you said you wanted to say, wanted the differences, right?
That
can
be created
in this task. Yeah, that is the, anyway, the task is to, you know, display sales order. I know you're not able to run it. I know the data is not there. So the task is
okay.
For me. You can take a final decision.
Yes.
It's up to you. No problem.
Yeah. For me, it is okay because they showed other examples as well.
Yeah. So nobody's taking other examples. So if you want to keep it on hold,
for me, it is okay.
Okay. Okay. So the last task is.
Gokul. Yeah. Chirag wants to add one point to.
Gokul, since we are going in for this task of difference. Okay, so I just wanted to add one small point. Brian has demonstrated AMDP with the parameter. What I wanted to know was, how do we pass the select option in that? Because I think that is a little complex thing that has to be.
Select option cannot be passed directly.
Yeah.
So it needs to be converted to string and then passed it.
So if that can be shown as a task as well, if possible, if you can take it.
You already have some examples.
No, I don't have it.
I can just share it with the team. Yeah. So I already have an example that I can
share. Yes. Share it with the team as well.
Yes, yes.
Simple, can I now update the task as well with the same details? Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Good.
Yeah. Thanks, sir. Last task.
Last task is related to me. Darshana here. Hi, all.
Hello.
Hello. Are you all able to see my screen?
Yeah, we see you.
Yeah, my task is related to BRF Plus with the setting, that is the configuration setting which I showing now. So that is related to the BRF Plus, how we can see the form and smartphone and all things in S/4HANA in BRF Plus. So first we need to run the BRF Plus transaction.
I can't see your screen.
Now it is visible.
No, not your screen is not visible.
Yeah, you share container screen one.
Just a moment, I will share it again. Now it is visible. Okay, this is the BRF Plus transaction, business rule framework it is. So first of all, we need to personalize the setting using user mode. There are two types of mode, simple and expert. So we need to choose the expert mode, and these are the basic settings that we have to do in the BRF Plus. Then click on save. After that, we need to upload one, import one XML note file. So with the XML import, we need to do that. Actually, I have already done. So there is a browse and all that settings, and then need to click on upload XML file. So first you need for that two requests. One is workbench request and second is customizing request. Then go to the SPRO transaction. Just a moment. In that SPRO, you need to define the business rule output determination, assign output channels, and define rule for the determination for master template. I have already done that. So what we have, like this only, whatever I have done the PPTs before, so like that only, this is the customizing thing. So configuration things that we need to do in SPRO things, assign output channel like printer, then IDOC and whatever the forms and what you like to add, you can add over there channels related things. And in the one transaction, I'm facing one issue, so I will execute that, then I'll show you. Just a moment. Yeah, here we add one extra line with the click on edit button, 81, and then click on the direct value input. And then sales document type, you have to mention that CCRE, and here we need to do the, we need to assign that ZST output type. and then dispatch time is 1, and again you have to check it and then activate it. So object is consistent and need to activate it. So that time I'm facing one error, I need to activate the services, then it will be created, that ZSO things. After that, output will be displayed. 90% I can say the part is completed, but I am facing one issue. So I will complete this at next session. So will it be okay for this time?
Yeah, I think we have this error, so that's the reason we're not able to. And who is the owner? Is it
Prachi. Prachi. Prachi, the past one.
Because already I have activated the SICF 3 services. Still, I don't know what is remaining. So, need to do R&D on that.
Fine. I think even I agree with Prachi. I think this is not your fault. It's more of a system. This thing we need to check. So. But let's keep it on hold. So let's not close this test. We just want to see
the
final output. I think you part, I think you've done the work fine. So let's try to complete it when the system is, you know, the settings are done, then let's try to complete it. Okay, is it okay, Prachi?
Yeah.
You are the task owner. Is it okay? We'll keep it on hold.
Yes.
Yeah. Any other questions? Anybody else related to what you know, Darshana was saying?
So what are the right now the task is not completed, but what are the forms we can use in VRSM?
Smart form we can assign, and also SAP script, I think so. And Adobe form also.
So in last session you told us that IDOC is not supported. So did you check that is it supporting IDOC?
No, I have not checked it, but IDOC is not supported. And NAST also is not.
Current PPT? In your current PPT, there is a different line there. See the third line? It tells us a different line.
Yeah, as a business partner, I think it is possible.
maybe this is on action 22, Darshana. Maybe IDOC one, could you please check and confirm us? Maybe similar to what Brian and Prem is checking. So please check this point. Whether it is still supporting IDOC, or is there any specific restriction, like only for certain cases it will support IDOC or not? Maybe you can check and inform the team.
Yes. That I have to check whether IDOC will support or not.
Yeah. But not now. You just check and then maybe you can let us know later.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, good question. Any other questions or anybody else? Okay then, I think there are no questions. I think, but BRF Plus is an interesting topic. So it's more about output determination as of now, but can be used for other places as well.
There one question like from my side. So in the S/4HANA, like I saw a lot of table is merging this S/4HANA as compared to ECC. So in similar way output type, so we have different transaction for different output type in the ECC. So in this system, for BRF Plus, all the output type is merged in this, or we have different transaction.
Okay, Darshana, you want to answer? Who is asking this? Hello.
Tafsir here. Hello, Tafsir.
Okay. Darshana, you want to answer that? Your question is more about whether the output types are merged or something, is it? Is that what you're asking?
Just say in ECC we have some time we have the SPRO sitting like we saw like in NAS we are configuring the output types, but for different modules it's giving different way of setting output type.
Correct.
So in S/4HANA how it is like for output type control?
Let me try to answer that. In S/4HANA, so you're not talking about having different output types. The output types are configurable. If you're talking about having one output type, two up to no, it's all completely depending on the requirement. If you want to have a separate output type similar to what you have right now, that part is going to continue. Only difference is VMware plus here, they will configure the output type. Suppose if you have 10 output types in the current systems, you're still going to continue with the 10 output types. There's no change in that. Only difference is, okay, output type 1, for which condition you want to configure it. Let's say for this customer or for this particular sales org, you want to print something or you want to send the IDOG, I don't know. Maybe that combination you maintain there, na? That part is replaced by BRPS, basically. Okay, the way you maintain, okay, for a different combination, something should be printed. For a different combination, this should be printed. So that only that configuration part, what you are referring, which you are doing now through NACE, is replaced by VRFLY. Okay, so number of output types, there's no directly. It's going to be same. It's something will be similar to what you have right now. That is not being impacted. Obviously, it's a different topic altogether.
Okay.
Only difference is how you are going to configure, that is different. And just to add to that, in the same system, you can have NACE as well as the new VRFLY. You can have BRF Plus activated for some of, let's say, for sales order or delivery. And for billing, probably you can have NAC, depending on the requirement. If you want to send IDOCs, suppose if it is not possible through BRF Plus, you can still continue with billing the old one, NAC. Both combinations are in the same system. Okay. Is that okay?
Yes.
Nupur, I think you can put it on hold, this one. And okay, thanks, Darshana. Thanks for the details. Yeah. Thanks, Darshana. And Darshana and team.
Thank you. It is real. I have one question related to connectivity. As we are able to create the project, but if we want to connect to SAP system, then we are not able to do it, because then we can go and check what are the tables available, the reports and everything. So that part we are not able to connect it, because project we can do it and then from there we can create a CDS view. But if we want to explore other things, then we are not able to connect to HANA system from Eclipse or HANA
system. But directly SAP, SAP you are able to access it, right? SAP GUI you are able to access it, right? Only from X.
Yes.
Yeah, I think somebody already reported. We'll check it further, yeah. We'll check it further to see what is wrong. Actually, we thought it should work fine. I think even Frame did some R&D, and I thought it was okay. Maybe some from Frame as
well. That is for a project, actually. From there, we can create a CDS view. But to connect to HANA system from Eclipse, that is yet not. So we are not able to
We'll check that. We'll see what is wrong and we'll try to correct it. Because we've done so much of work this week. In 2 weeks, I think we've done a really good work. So let's continue with that. We'll check the connectivity as well and we'll talk about that. Huh? Is that okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. And thanks. Alupur, you can put this one on hold. Any other point? This recording, I will share it. Alupur and Sushil, please help in that.
Yeah.
Okay. So thanks, guys. And thanks, all.
Thank you all. Bye.
Hello.
Thank you very much.
Hello.
Bye, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you.
Gokul, we have a point. We have a point to be discussed.
Yeah, okay, good. So, Gokul, from next time onwards, can we just keep this call a bit earlier?
I think it's okay. For me, it's okay. The time was discussed earlier. I'm absolutely fine. I don't know whether anybody has any issues. how much time you want, like, you know, half an hour earlier or something, I don't know.
Yeah, half an hour or 1 hour earlier. Because
it can keep on 5 p.m.
Yes, because the call generally goes on for 1.5 hours or more than that.
Okay, even I was also thinking maybe you should schedule for 1.5 hours. It normally goes for that. Maybe you can keep it earlier. Yeah, no more. No more. Please help me to find out whether the time slot is okay, yeah, because you can check with the team members.
Okay. Okay.
You need to talk to one same team as well. Please talk to Suresh as well.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. We can reschedule it based on the requirements. We can talk to people who are coming from other time zones as well, I think. So,
yeah.
We'll pre-pone it. That's absolutely fine.
Okay, Gokul, then we'll. Yeah.
All right, then. Thanks, all. Thanks, guys. Thanks
yeah,
Captain. Thanks, Sapur and Sendil. Thanks, all. Thank you. Bye.
Everyone.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.